Today, 14th of October, Wednesday, we are taking the formal lab class formally. But before that, I must tell that the main thing of any system development, I say system, not program, I'll tell what is the difference between system and program. What is the difference? Program with hardware is a system, basically. So you have to have matching hardware. So the hardware may be your server, which is whether it's a Linux server, whether it's an Intel server, whether it's a IBM server, right now even your mobile phone can be a server. Okay, right now the 8GB mobile phone, you can act as a server also. So, and the program is basically linked with the data structure. So data structure, if it is very, very powerful, then your program development time is less. That is one of the negative point of the C. C, only the array data structure is there, and structure. And union. Union is hardly used. You know, probably union, there is two data structures, structure and union. Union is hardly used. Earlier it was developed and union, because at that time the memory is very scarce. So the highest amount of memory is taken by the union. And right now structure is better. Structure is there in Python and Java also, in much better form. With along with the structure, we have add methods also as object-oriented programming. This structure is you can take it as a basic building block of a class. There only the data portion, that if you put some method, generally called method in function, we sort of, whenever object-oriented programming, we call this as a method, not a function. Then if you add some structure with some method, then you can call it a class and you can create object out of it. Okay, so now coming to the discussion between array and linked list, C is only available with array. Array is the same kind of things. It may be byte array, it may be integer array. Integer, you know, in C generally takes 4 bytes, most of the cases 4 bytes, very few cases 2 bytes. 16-bit compiler where is there, everywhere is 4 bytes, and floating point is 8 bytes, long is 10 bytes. So you can have a contiguous allocation, you can store it in an array, and linked list is as demand basis, you can put these things. They are both are very powerful, but my hunch is, and always linked list is much more powerful. I am telling you, array very fast. You can, if you know the index, you can get the element. If I know the element, if I know the fifth element, I can go fifth and get it down. But if you say, if you want to say the maximum, who is the maximum, or this, you say I have to go hop and see the maximum. So the complexity is O(n). But if we say if the index is there, your complexity is O(1). Like if a stack, if you push or pop, that is O(1). See, if the stack amount is there, if you push O(1), pop is O(1). So that is a fantastic example of O(1) complexity. Array, if the index is found, that is also O(1), but not always a successful, because you want to say maximum or minimum. But array is desired. In fact, array is totally lost if you put certain things into it. Say I want to insert one item here, so if then I have to make another item here, and I'll push every item right hand side, then put here. So array becomes disaster if you frequently add insertion or deletion, then array is a disaster. So but in real life, you know, every data structure, there will always have data coming in and coming out. That is one negative point of array. So if you put something, that has to wave back, but in linked list that is not there, you just cut the link, you put certain things and join the link. Very simple. That is the advantage of linked list. And linked list, you don't have to say how much size should be. So in real life, you can add more element, and you know, in C it is very easy, malloc and calloc. In Python and Java, they'll automatically give this. So that is great. So linked list is another thing, is most of the problems in real life, in computer science, it can be put in a tree form, like in a binary search tree, or in a, you know already, or heap, or if you see in a graph. So any problem in a tree or graph, that cannot be put in an array. Definitely not. Because array is basically single dimensional. You can make it multi-dimensional. But if you put a value of graph in an array, a multi-dimensional array, now most of the elements will be empty and a lot of space will be used. But I can put a graph through it several kinds of linked list. I can linked list like adjoining list, which node is connected with which other node. I make a linked list for every node. Take as a dictionary. You create is a Python is a dictionary. Your key values are the node and the values are the linked list, the node which connected with other nodes. Okay, so this dictionary is nothing but a representation of graph. That is great. The Python gives support. Python, but C it's difficult. You have to make everything on it. So array, first of all, array is one problem is you have to tell beforehand that this is the space I want given. Dynamic sizing array, it is not possible in C. In Python, yes, it is there. We have a different name. So list is, you can call it a dynamic array. You can put different objects in it and it can be dynamic. And linked list, another thing. That is a linked list is, you can, if you add something here or delete something here, if you add something here, then it takes one. So if a data structure frequently modified or changed, then linked list is much, much better than array. Array is, if your data is almost fixed, you have no change in data, and if you put the data in a sorted form, then the array is good, because then you know your midpoint is the, you can binary search, you can get it in log n time, because you know the midpoint, and if it is greater than or lesser than, then you know is it greater than, it must be that half, or is it lesser than, you go to the again midpoint, so that you get the divide and conquer, then you get the log n advantage. So definitely, if you put any sorted number in an array, it's a log n advantage. But in linked list, if you put the sorted number in a linked list, that at the log n advantage, you cannot get it. Because in linked list, always you can go from this way, one way and another. But linked list will be powerful, will be very powerful if it is double, is a doubly linked. In a double linked list, here the deletion, you have to always get it from the, because you know that this one, you don't know this one. So if it is deleted, you have to connect to this to this, but in a double linked list, you just drop it and you just connect this and connect this. So double linked list deletion is O1, but in the single linked list deletion is O(n), insertion also. So double linked list is, in real life, the double linked list, because you need only two pointers. One is the forward pointer, one is backward pointer. Here I have shown is single linked list. So double linked list is used heavily for any representation of tree, graph, everywhere, any data structure, live data structure, even the list. Okay. So any question you can put on, I can, or you can put your all your question at the end. We'll discuss this thing. Because the linked list will come again and again, because all those binary search tree, your heap tree, these are also, heap is different than binary search tree. Binary search tree, maximum right hand side should be always better, left hand side always lesser, and no duplicate values can be there, and heap is different. Mean heap, the minimum should go to the top, maximum should the max to the go to the top, but this is a binary tree, and this is fully complete binary tree, just complete binary. So there is some difference, and all these trees can be saved in the linked list. That is a great. Okay. So next slide. Yeah. So these are the structures. These are the data structures that are available in any programming languages. More like Python, these are available. Like C, array is available, but ordered array, stack. We have to maintain. We have to create a stack. You know, you have to create a stack already doing the C classes. You can create a stack with an array. Yes, you can create a stack with a view. But these are the things that are almost built in. Some of the things are built in the Python. Yes, a linked list. That is a linked list, slow search, in quick insertion and quick deletion. There is binary tree, red black tree that will cover 2, 3, 3. These are all there for efficient data. Because if you put your data in a very intelligent platform, and that is a tested platform, your programming complexity will be much, much less. And your development time will be much, much less. That is the great thing about the Python. Yes, that is the difference between array and linked list. Array is resizing is expensive, yes, because in C you have to declare the dimension of the array. After this, if you have to even one element you want to add, they will be out of index error. Like if you have a bank account in State Bank of India, if your money is 10,000, if you draw a check 10,000 one rupee, it will be bounced. Same thing. Then you will not get any money. Same thing in array, out of bound exception. Yeah. So resizing and it is a no checking. And see, another problem is if an array, if you go out of the array, and there is no checking. You just the program will exit and come out, and they go error and blue stream something come. But these are the things are not there in Python. They better handle. Python array is there in as a numeric array, as a numpy, but here is a link, here is a list is there. Linked list in C also you can build it by node value and with a pointer. It's a dynamic sizing. Every time you create a memory by malloc or scallop, you know what is the difference between malloc and scallop. Malloc gives raw data, raw byte without initialization. Scallop gives initialized data, dynamic. And insertion deletion and efficient, I have to. Insertion deletion is very efficient here. That is most of the cases. Random access is indexing is very fast, pretty fast. Here no random access and no memory waste. You cannot say that because even if the memory will be reserved and blocked for it, it will be there in your program memory in your stack area, or it can be a global memory. It will be blocked. And in a linked list, you can take the data your heap program heap. This is a sequential access is faster. Yes, they are in the same place. Sequential access is slower because it go by link, by hop, by hop. Yes. Next, we go to the directory to run the program. Go to the program there. Is the screen visible? Anyone?
Yes,
sir. Thank you. Thank
yes,
you.
Sir.
And if anything, any question, you can always put it at the end. Whenever I ask for a question, you can ask any question. Thank you very much. So here, we basically create a class, a node, where this, and this is a constructor. You know, this is a constructor. And this is a self. This is like a this in Java. We always said self. You can put it any other name. You can put it say selfie. Then you have to have a put selfie here. So I think it is better. It is a convention that the first parameter should be self, and you all the data comes to the self dot data. This is kind of a this variable in Java. Same thing is Java. So this is a constructor. You know the Python constructor. Unlike the name of this, always only one constructor is there, and that is it. That is very private. Why this is private? Because you can call from outside. Whenever you create an object, constructor will be automatically called. And this is a linked list. I am creating a linked list, and this is a doc string. If you have a doc string with the value, it is goes to the code itself, and you can. It is a variable __ doc string. I will say. And if you have a multiple lines, you have a three quotes, you know, Java comments, three quotes, there is a doc string. And here it's a linked list constructor. Head is null, like it's a like, nothing is there. Then I go, yeah, hope so. Yeah. So here I see I am creating a object linked. L list, this is object. I am creating an object out of it. Print list, print linked list, class name, __ doc _. That is, I wish to print the doc string. I wish to print the doc string here. I wish to print the doc string from the object. So I will see the both values are same. I can print the from the class level doc string, because doc string is a common string. So that is the common. And this is I am printing the everything is a ID, you know, there's a, everything is object, even an integer is object, even a float is object, and you get the value, print ID. So you can be sure what is object and what is the type. I'll see what is the type. I think this is always a good practice whenever you are learning, always see for debugging also, you should ID and type and then print. And you then initialize first node. You, node is the, you know, remember, say I am creating a node with a constructor value A. So I am creating a node and list head is equal to first node. I am down, I put it first node and list. This is my first version. So I just run it. You also please run it. Yeah. See here, class linked list is working version 1. This is a come from docstring. Line 1 docstring, second one docstring. This is the object ID. This will be different from your different platform. And this is interesting. You see, this is a class underscore underscore main underscore. This is my program. This is main program. Under this, the linked list class. So you see the namespace. What is the namespace? Namespace here is underscore underscore main underscore. So within this, the link. And first is none. Whenever not value something none, then I put value A and then I print the linked list A none. That is, as a linked list is formed. But this program is much better if you go for version 3. You just go to the version 3, please. Yeah, version. Version 3, what we have done, this is the multi-line docstring, three codes. And here, see, constructor is little tricky. So constructor here is not none, then pop 0, it add it, all the elements. And this iteration is there, it's iterable. So I have to add method, you know already iteration, because most of the objects are iterable. And you can present, then you can add first. That is what I have told you, that any linked list you can add any point. At first, at last is O1. At first, at last, I've done it. Then add after some point, and then add after we use it with some known values, like there is no queue there. So I try to add CC after queue. It will raise an exception. And first try will write a CC after C. There will be no exception because C is already there, so it will be added and you will see it. And whenever you try to add CC after Q, then because there is no Q, it will raise an exception. So just see, it's the same. We are creating a linked list, and these are the initial value. This is a much powerful. We are creating a linked list with the constructor itself, and the print linked list we see. First print is the docstring, then both ways, but I think later one you can see only one, because that is helpful for debugging. When the program is not running, your docstring will help from which function your program is doing. So it is always, whenever you create a function or class, you have one line docstring you should maintain. That is that is recommended. Yeah, that is this is a practice. I always see ID is a type. Yes, it is always print list for node. What I am doing it here, I am doing it here vertically. What are the values? I first one is ABCD. Now I want ABCD. So that is the reason I put it in the for loop. Then I add first U. First we add ABCDF. Then we add U. Then print list, then U is coming, then again add first V, O1, time, you know, complexity print list, then add last, we have already method, add last method, add Z into it, print list, then here L list C after, because we add node CC after C, it is there, it will be added, then we try to add node CC after Q, it will be exception. So it will create exception. So I do because it will create an exception. Okay, we can run it. We'll see it one. Everything will be fine. Let's see. Now I'm running it right now. It will create exception. Yes, rate comes because it the exception will be there. Yeah, let's see. See here, first one is docstring fine, object is created, class is created. Like this is whenever it is created, A, B, C, D, it's printed. Now whenever in for loop, because iterable function, it is printed like A, B, C, D. Then I add, at first U is added, then V is added to the linked list, then Z is added, this one is Z is added, yeah, Z is added. Then the exception comes because we have to say after CC, so better we do it a comment line, I think, let's see, yeah. Yes, so what we do, we try to make it comment line. This is some keyboard I have issues. Let's delete it. Because I keyboard sometimes go here. Yeah. I think there should not be no error. Yeah, no error. So after C, CC is error. If you try to put CC after Q, the exception will come. But you can try once more. So this is okay. Program is okay. Then I'll just copy this, copy selection. Then I put after Q. Because no Q is there, great. Then try to same exception will come. It will come. Yeah, the exception Q is not found. That is exception. Yeah. So that's okay. But why you might ask why that earlier is not there? First C after CC is not printed. I have to check why it is not printed. I have given the command now after QCC. Okay, this is your home task. You check it, what is there. So, this is I formally two things I must tell that from my earlier class, lambda function, I have told you earlier also, Sarah has also discussed today. Lambda function, there is no name, that is called anonymous function, and that will be always in a single line. And then you can ask why for lambda function. Lambda function is sometimes your program become much more prettier and you call this function again and again, and so you can put it in lambda function. It's a one line function, strictly one line function. You can put the lambda function within a function, so that is great, and it comes from the Lisp programming language. Actually they recommend it to the originator here, Van, so developed that this is a lambda function. And now the platform is open for any question, and now you must present your one by one your chart. First you please ask question.
Sir, what is the disadvantage of linked list?
Disadvantage, because yes, this linked list disadvantage is that what is array string, you cannot get it with 0-1 time anything. So if you want to say middlemost element, the linked list in an array, if you have a 10 element array, say if you want the middle point, say 5th or 6th, you go O1 time, complexity O1, but in a linked list, you have to traverse by 0th element, 1st element, 2nd element, so complexity is O n. So searching is O n, in array it is O1, but the advantage of linked list is it can add, delete in O1 time, but in array, add deletion takes lot O n time. So that a linked list is dynamically sized, arrays cannot be dynamically sized. So some points we use array, where we know that these are our typical data, we not change much, then we put in array. And where the data is dynamic, most of the cases data is dynamic, you put in a linked list. And another advantage is, with a linked list advantage, if you think of as a dictionary, if you take the dictionary, your your key values at the node and in and values at the linked list. So in any graph, a graph is nothing, it's the vertices and edges. So if you put all your vertices as your key values and edges is a linked list, the vertices is connected to which vertices is a linked list, then you can represent a graph a very compact way in a dictionary with a linked list in a Python. That's great because dictionary is a built-in linked list. We'll see, you don't have to write much. There's a collection program. In the collection you can get a DQ. Then the linked list is just a 3 lines program. Here it is a few more lines, but if you do it on C, it is a maybe 50 lines program, minimum 50 lines program. But C has some other advantages, we will not go to it. Have you got it? There is always a pros and cons of array.
Yes, sir.
Array, whenever your size is fixed, your data is fixed, then array is best. So if you know, say your numbers, say your roll numbers and everything, it is better to put in array. But no changing. Your first year you will enter and finally you will go. So we can put in an array as a roll number, as an index, then array is good because we can find it. But linked list is good for other activities. Where is the dynamic size? Yeah. Any question?
One question.
Yeah, tell me.
So in linked list, we need to specify a position of an element. Like we have linked the whole list. Is the position required, or we can do without the position? Like in some programs, we see the pass position of the element. Like while inserting
more?
An element.
Yeah, just can you tell me once more?
Sir, I'm asking, do we need to specify? Like in array, we have index of an element.
Yeah.
In linked list, we don't have anything as such.
Yeah.
Do we? But in some programs, we see that they specify certain position of the element, like first element, second element, like that.
Yeah.
So is it necessary to do it in that way, or in the way we are doing, like we are linking the list and we are not specifying any positions?
Yeah, basically linked list, there is no visibility inside. So linked list you can only access from the front end. There is no, you can you say linked list position number one, it is not, it is a fit. You can go, you have to always go from head to 1, 2, 3, 4. So it will be 1. So you can make positions, you can go from the head only. And if it is a double linked list, if it is at the end of the list, we can proceed from there. So double linked list, it takes much space, but it is deletion is much better. Deletion is quicker, 0, 1. But single linked list disadvantage is you can go only one way, not reverse way. And coming back to your question, you can tell your position, but it will take that in single linked list, it will be O-N. Yes, am I answered your question?
Okay. Yes, sir. Okay, sir.
Linked list, but linked list is very powerful for representation of a tree, representation of any graph, because whenever in computer science, your data structure, I think you have started data structure, the most of the problems is the binary search tree, sorting, searching, you have to put data. We all that put data in a binary search tree or heap. They are all basically binary trees. Binary trees, it can be very easily represented by a linked list. You have both links, like a binary tree can have a left link and right link. It is basically a linked list. And so that's it. And any graph can be put, I have told you, like a dictionary. So linked list is very, very powerful for putting any data. The array is basically fixed size of a thing and you can put it. Array is not that way efficient. For known data, there is no such addition and deletion. Array is good, but for any other purposes, linked list is more versatile, more powerful. It takes as demand basis, you can ask memory by malloc and calloc, and in Python, the Python virtual memory will allocate the necessary memory and it will take out. So linked list, I think it is always much more powerful. Okay, have I answered your question? Okay, can anybody show your presentation?